And please welcome your celebrity goalies for this event. Women's hockey pioneer, Manon Rayon. And actor-producer, Wyatt Russell.
Celebrating one of his favorite players from the Minnesota Wild, Kirill Kaprizov.
Is my mic hot for this or no?
So they will announce each individual shooter, and Kaprizov is going to pay tribute to Alexander Ovechkin here in his first All-Star game. He will salute a man who might end up being the all-time greatest goal scorer in NHL history.
He's well on his way, isn't he?
Ovi couldn't be here because we know he's just going for it.
Right,
he's
down just to going the for it. Yellow wax laces.
Ripping shooting right-handed too, like Ovi said.
And it's good.
There we go.
Well, you want guys to have personality, there's an opportunity to show it. Kaprizov, what a player he is. And as you said, Kev, going the opposite hand and doing the Ovi right on, he gets, of course, a great eight from everyone.
I mean, that's what the fans want, right? They want some entertainment.
We know Alex couldn't
Ovi's
be here.
One of the best at it, so if he's not going to be here, you got to honor him somehow.
You wanted to send him a message Kaprizov's in Russian. Go ahead.
Parents making their first trip to North America in recent weeks to watch him, and they are here up in the stands.
Awesome job. Listen, on behalf of everybody at the NHL, we're thinking of you, Ovi. You should be here with us. Rest up. Get well soon.
Actually made a nice move there.
He did. He actually kept pretty good control, didn't he?
That's the Troy Terry move that he didn't pull off in the last event, but he won a gold medal with it, the World Juniors.
Calder Trophy winner, dollar bill
next
Kirill.
Up.
Just a note on the goaltenders, of course, Menno played for the Las Vegas Thunder. In fact, the biggest crowd they ever had was in a game she played. I think this is going to be a lot of fun. Here's Trevor Zegras with a ode to dodgeball.
Well, there's a reason Trevor is here, and this is very much all about what he is. He's done some amazing things in this young man's career.
You can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball.
We're going to do the blindfold trick. Here we go. Jimmy, put a blindfold on.
Get some help from his teammate.
It's a bold strategy, Simmer. Let's see if it works out. So apparently there's going to be, oh, here we go. The mascot's coming out to try and distract. Look out. Wow.
Are you kidding me?
Well, that was more Guy Lafleur than Pete Lafleur, wasn't it?
Judges, what do you have to say about that?
I don't know what just happened, but that was really cool.
Well, the kid just, he's got incredible skills. And there's the numbers, nines and tens all around. He got there so quickly they didn't even get the dodgeballs out to get him in time.
I was going to say, that's why he has to be here, isn't it?
He's trying to work the judges a little bit too. He's right over him. He's like, what are you guys giving me? Just a little kid. He's just a kid having fun that loves the game still. I know there's been a lot of debate about his skill set and some of the things he's tried to pull off, but look at the smile on his face right now. This kid just loves hockey.
That is unbelievable.
Well, and so how many kids for the next couple of weeks are going to be trying that on the backyard or the outdoor rink?
That's your highlight of the night.
What do you think, kiddo?
You have guys just sitting here on the bench, NHL superstars, just shaking their head and laughing and saying, there's no chance I could ever do that. Like, the best players in the world are amazed by what this kid can do with the puck.
Not only not do it, but have the guts to even try it. I mean, chance of failure. Look at that reaction there. Johnny, he's got some skills of his own, but wow, what a moment. Well done.
I don't know if a young guy's ever had that swagger since Jeremy Roenick came into the league. And Trevor Zegras certainly backs it up with that talent. And here's another bright youngster, 20 years of age, the youngest in this competition, Jack Hughes of New Jersey.
Well, he's right in that generation, right, with Zegras. I'm thinking you'll see something special here, too.
A little juggling going on for you.
Just kidding.
Hey, see, you put yourself out there. It's not an easy thing to do. And Manon does a pretty good job of staying with him and getting a little poke check out there.
You're in Vegas, that didn't feel totally right. Should we get some magic in the mix?
I think we can get some magic in the mix. If there's anything Vegas can do, it's magic. Bring it out. Let's do it again.
You know, these two guys have been working together.
Judges, pay attention here.
It's a little David Copperfield influence.
It's Vegas. You never know what you're going to get, right?
If we did a competition for goal celebrations, Jack Hughes might have the winner already this year when he won in overtime and threw a stick in the stands.
It was a beauty, wasn't it?
Unbelievable.
You got the tape on, you got the top hat. That's perfect right there, you guys. Center ice, magic box. What's going to happen here?
I need an instruction manual for this one, guys.
It's an elaborate setup.
Nothing in the box.
Let's see his presentation here. Okay.
Just like any magician, he's showing us that the box is empty. What do you got here? You got a mini stick. Very good. A small stick. Put that in the box. A mini glove. It's nice.
Don't mean to be the spoiler alert, but there's a hole in the ice underneath the box.
A little mini devil coming out.
Yes, that's small equipment.
You need two gloves, two mini gloves. Closing up the box, that's nice. Well, that's it.
Okay, three times around the box.
Abracadabra.
Let's see what's in the box. Oh, it's Mini Jack Hughes!
It is, Mini Jack Hughes.
Wow!
And a huge panorama with a stick
going to
the ground.
There you go.
He cloned himself. He just cloned himself on national TV.
Mini Jack Hughes, burying it up and over it all. Stand by, judges, what do we got?
Well, if the future wasn't Jack Hughes, it might be Mini Jack Hughes.
You know what? You see the look on some of these youngsters' faces. They look like they're about 12, 13 years old. And you know what? It's always trying to push the envelope, do something creative, and here you go. Well done, Jack. And Mini Jack.
Mini Jack was born with the same mitts as Big Jack. Nice hands on the kid.
Absolutely. I mean, are you kidding me? Tiny Hughes, he could be drafted by Arizona next year.
Darren Waller.
And he needed that finish, didn't you?
In the house, brother.
Tens across the board.
And Jack Hughes,
I'm trying to figure out how Trevor Zegras didn't get an 11.
Mind blowing. Nick Hughes will be a legend.
You think we can see that maybe in a celebration in the end zone one day?
Yeah, we're about to pull
it off. We're going to do it. Let's go. We're moving on.
Mentioned Wyatt Russell also in goal. He was an old teammate in college of Cam Talbot. In fact, he had to place a call to Cam to get the equipment because he hasn't played in some time. And, well, the next is going to be a tribute to the hangover. Look out.
What Vegas trip wouldn't have a hangover?
Alex DeBrincat. And I wonder how much input Patrick Kane had on this. Playing the role of Allen, of course, Zach Galifianakis. And
we got our Mike Tyson look, too.
And now for the Chicago Blackhawks.
Baby's got the shades.
Better know tonight as
we're going to call you Alan now. Obviously representing the Hangover, and you've got quite the Hangover crew here. Derek Carr in the house, ready to toss you a pass. What made you think of this one?
You know, I just came here to Vegas, hoping to do my best in this challenge, and it just came together nicely.
It just came together nicely. You brought Derek Carr with a football. I'm going to skate over to Derek really quickly. Derek, did you ever think when the Raiders came to Las Vegas, you'd be standing here in T-Mobile Arena at the NHL All-Star Skills Competition?
No, this is unbelievable. I'm thankful to be a part of it. Las Vegas, we love you. Can't wait to see you guys next year.
Derek Carr, Vegas!
It's quite a posse he brought with him, huh?
Here we go! Oh, the touchdown! Can he finish?
Well, you want to push the boundaries. There's a great example of how to do it, and what better city to do it in than Las Vegas.
You say you get the resources when you're in Vegas, don't you? John Hamm.
John Hamm.
He's a St. Louis guy.
Wow, yeah.
Oh, yeah. The St. Louis-Chicago rivalry is alive and well.
Mr. Hamm, why the seven? It's Derek Carr just threw a missile touchdown pass.
How many points is a touchdown worth?
Riddle me this, John Hamm.
Boy, he got the roll off the post, too. It looked like it was going to be off the bar and out. Wide left. Instead, it's off and in.
Good job by Alan DeBrincat.
I wouldn't want to be going right now. You kind of get the one up going. Last couple have been pretty spectacular. I don't know what's next. Is there anything next? Or are we done?
We've got one. Alex Pietrangelo still to come, and
you got
to
have the home
Vegas
ice advantage.
To bring
yeah.
Home.
The last player for the Adidas NHL breakaway challenge.
And something might be up because. Pietrangelo's not the first guy you'd think of with Vegas as far as a breakaway challenge, but maybe he's here to surprise.
Pietrangelo just getting right to it.
I don't think that was his A move.
No, I don't think that was.
You got to come over here, brother.
He needs a redo here. As well,
listen,
I think.
This is Las Vegas. We've got celebrity judges. And that just wasn't very flashy, bro.
I should have just had Marchie's kid go shoot. Probably better at it than I am.
Well, listen, the little guys look fantastic. But, you know, this is Las Vegas. It's our home born. I think our Vegas Golden Knight fans want to see something a little flashy. What do you think? Vegas?
Carrot Top is in one.
Oh, I don't know, Carrot Top. Can you get this crowd going? Let's go, Vegas. Let's do this. Pietrangelo, let's light it up.
Vegas.
All right, judges, let's see the scores. He had the drum line, he had some neon.
John. He's trying to be creative
and trying to make sure that.
The home team
is a popular guy in Vegas.
That is a 64. That is your winner. Vegas.
Well, there may have to be a recount. Got a marching band. We had a magician, and well, I guess we had two magicians because Trevor Zegras certainly qualifies in that category. And it won't be the last hangover.
No, I don't think. I think it's just the beginning of that for sure. But well done. Got to try to push the envelope, break some barriers, and good sport for Petrangelo going to take the drum home to his family.
Okay, Kevin, take it away.
Alex, what's going on right now?
You know what? When you got kids, you just do anything you can to make them happy. Look at this. Might bring this thing home.
Just tugging on the old heartstrings that win this event, eh?
You know what? We're trying to come up with something creative. I don't have any shoot-up moves like these young bucks do, so I just have to come up with something different.
Oh, great job. Kids are enjoying it.
That's all that matters. My kids are loving it. That's important.
Have a good weekend, bud.
A pop of triplets. Well, that was entertaining. Kirill Kaprizov with his Ovechkin. Still can't believe that. Unbelievable dodgeball shootout from Trevor Zegras. We've had some magic from both Jack Hughes and a show band for the hometown favorite.